We're telling the story of the Marshall University football team that was lost in a plane crash November 14th, 1970. They were coming back from a game against East Carolina. They were on approach. They were just about home. And right before they hit the runway, they clipped a tree, and all 75 people on board were lost. All the members of the football team, the leaders of the community, and it decimated the community.
When the plane crash happened, and, well, there's so many people that was from the town that were on that crash. So it had a lot more impact than just the team being on it. That's how it was, like a family.
It was a tragedy, and it's affected us till this day. We still go back to when that happened, and it's been a huge impact on our community and the people who live here.
Everyone is either related to that plane crash, either they lost family members or by friendships or just by the lore. I mean, the town, it's the roots of the town. That's a major part of their history and their through line.
And this is a story about what we do as human beings when immeasurable grief comes into our life. Without reservation, the people you love want you to be the best you can be, to follow your dream and move on and live a full life. So that's ultimately what the community comes to understand, that the best way we can honor those who have fallen is to move forward with the football program, play hard, and keep the program alive.
Excuse me, young man. Excuse me, this is a private meeting.
I don't mean to interrupt, sir, but I think there's something y'all need to hear.
If you have anything to say, we'll set up a time for you to come by my office.
Well, no, sir. I ain't got nothing to say. But they do.
Thank you, Lord.
Excuse me, young man, this is a private meeting.
The thing that I want to make sure everybody understands, this is not a football story. This is a story about faith and hope and integrity, character, loyalty, perseverance. Because when I came down here, I thought I was rebuilding a football team, and I quickly found out the heart of the community was taken out.
Came to Huntington so I could shoot these real faces and make sure that you were the people that embodied the movie. So thanks again, and let's have some fun.
B-Mark.
We are Marshall! We are Marshall!
We took great pains to be as authentic as possible, because in something like this, where the true story is really more amazing than anything we can come up with, there's no need to sort of fictionalize, there's no need to dramatize events that are already, so dramatic.
Now we're gonna change the camera position a little bit and go again. That was really, really great.
I think that everybody involved with the film feels that responsibility to do the story, give 110% and do everything they can to tell the story with all the passion and commitment and dedication that they possibly can.
Let's go for it all the way. It'll read and reverberate throughout the rest of the world so people will remember what this community's all about.
Roll sound, please.
Roll in!
Sound speed.
Well, I read about it when I was in college. I went to Florida State, where Red Dawson went too. He was the coach who didn't get on the plane, the assistant coach. And at the 30th anniversary of the crash, when I was a senior in 2000, the student newspaper had picked up an article about it. I just jotted it down, and then 5 years later I was in Hollywood, and I was a screenwriter, and I had a deal at Warner Brothers, and they asked what I wanted to do, because I owed them my next project, and this one has just always stuck with me. I spent about 3 weeks in Huntington meeting everybody, sat down with lots and lots of people, but mainly Jack and Red. Jack was really, really involved and really did a great job of keeping us honest and protecting things that were important to him and were important to, you know, other people in the town, and made sure that we've got the right people in the script and reflected you know, the best possible story that we could.
We are Marshall!
We are Marshall!
We are Marshall!
I read the script. I thought it was particularly well written, and I just responded to it immediately from a very guttural, emotional place. And I'm a big fan of Hoosiers and Something for Joey and Brian Song, and naturally, you know, Remember the Titans. And I thought, hey, what can I do to that genre to add my two bits to it and take it even higher?
You're so scared to introduce me to your girlfriend.
Listen, stop being so overconfident, bro. I rock, paper, scissors for
tickets. Let's go, right now.
I didn't want to shoot this on a Hollywood soundstage. I wanted to be in the streets of Huntington, West Virginia. I wanted to soak up the atmosphere.
You know, give yourself lots of room, everybody.
I went to Huntington twice before I even agreed to do the picture, and I talked to a great many people who are intimately related to the event, and I was so taken by their passion and just how it's on the sleeve of every single citizen of that town.
Hey, can't have anybody come further than the edge of the fountain, otherwise we'll miss you, okay?
So one thing that was very cool to me is that in the time that we were there, progressively, you started to feel the film set, the story that we're telling, become a part of the town. The town was embracing it more so. It became more than just storytellers from Hollywood coming into town telling a story about our town. It became we were telling it with them. They really started to embrace us.